Child and Family Services Minister Kerry Irvin Ross announced proposed amendments that would support traditional method of care for Indigenous children here at Thunderbird House before most of the province's Indigenous leaders.
Vision and her experience in helping guide us to the place of today, which really is a beginning of much more work to be done, but a new way of supporting families. Today we are announcing the legislative changes to the Family Services Act. It sounds kind of bureaucratic and technical, but let me explain what it is. What it is today is we are stepping aside. We are listening to the many, many people before us. Grand Chief Nipinak reminded me about 5 years ago when he met with Premier Selinger and spoke about customary care as a way to move forward. He's had to have a lot of patience with us, but we're here today. It is the next phase of devolution. We heard it in the AJI. We heard it loud and clear in Bring Our Children Home. The Hughes Inquiry reinforced that. And the TRC report said we must. So we're here today to acknowledge the importance of customary care, acknowledge the importance of communities caring for their children, of parents sitting at the table with their community, the helpers, and coming up with a plan that supports them. One thing that we need to highlight is that with customary care, the parents always maintain guardianship. They are always an active partner, and that is a significant change in our system. What else is very important is cultural identity, acknowledging the linguistics, acknowledging the traditions and the importance. All of our goals is to reduce the number of children in care. And I strongly believe that this is a step to do that. Today is removal of the barriers. What comes after that are consultations immediately with leadership, with chiefs and councils across the province, with the CEOs of the authorities and the agencies and families, and talk about customary care, what does it mean to you, and come up with an initiative of how we implement it. I know that we will challenge many people, because it is a totally different way of doing business. We have to do it differently. We will sit down, we will work together, we will support communities, support their plans, and acknowledge them. There is many people that need to be acknowledged, but I'd like to first start by acknowledging these fine men and women that represent our communities in the province of Manitoba. They represent I must thank Elder Daniels for his words, his honesty, and his passion that he shared, and the Red Bear Drummers for giving us that beat that's going to help carry us on this journey. There are six agencies that we are going to begin this work with, and I'd like to acknowledge them because they are going to be leaders. Customary care, it is new to me, but not new to Indigenous people. This has been the practice for generations. We will be working with six agencies: Opaskwak Cree Nation CFS, Island Lake First Nation CFS, Sandy Bay, Dakota Ojibwe, West Region, and we still are talking with Cross Lake and finalizing. So I want to Take today, celebrate. Tomorrow we get to work. I'd like to acknowledge the CEOs and the work that we're going to ask of you as we move forward, and the leaders in the community of the agencies, but also the frontline staff that will be challenged. A special thanks, as I said, to Diane and Shalyn McKay for their work, Heidi Berman, and the other people of Family Services that have come together, and we've pushed the limits, but I am so proud today to stand with all of you, and as I want to say, get the heck out of the way so communities can take the lead. This is the next step in evolution. So thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for opening us up in a good way. A lot of knowledge to drum. And of course, all of our leadership who are here today on this momentous occasion where we actually affirm and recognize the tears of our grandmothers and our aunties and our mums who began the process of talking about customary care within the public spaces that were created during the early days of the AJI-CWI. Many of those elders are not with us any longer, but I believe that they would rejoice in the acknowledgement of what they shared with us 2 decades ago, I believe, or maybe even longer than that, when we began talking about methods and process of customary care within our communities and within our families as part of a healing journey that we must all go on in the aftermath of our residential school experiences and in the aftermath of our apprehensions that we've been through throughout the 60s scoop and through the evolution of this new child welfare system. The moment of my participation in the discussion on customary care begins when I sit with the Premier of the province of Manitoba privately, and he and I talk about some of the targets that we could potentially pursue in collaboration. One of the items from front and center for me was about customary care and the discussion about implementing some of these key pieces of the AJI-CWI to move the markers along. I know that since then, there's been a tremendous amount of discussion focused on the polarity or the seeming divergence between what I do in leadership and what the province was trying to do in their leadership. And I believe that we've always needed to maintain a sense of urgency. We've always needed to maintain a friction between the collision of Western European ideas and the nation state that we live within and our own focus on who we are as the original people of these lands. I believe that there's always had to be that there because we can never become too comfortable. We can never become too comfortable in the way the systems are operating today. We have to recognize that there are far too many children who are separated from families, and we must forever be diligent and persistent in making sure we're doing everything we can to bring these families together again and to bring healing to our families and our communities, because it is healing that is going to lead to the self-determination that gives way to the self-government, that truly empowers that reconciliation era that is now beginning amongst us as families in our communities. I reflect upon my own upbringing in this consideration. I think of what has brought me here today into the work that I do as a leader. I think about my attachment to my family, and I was raised in a customary care environment after I was apprehended from the hospital when I was a baby, and I was given back to my family. My mom then gifted me to my grandparents in the customary way of our people. And I got to see what happens in my community. I got to see my great-grandmother tending the garden. I got to see my uncles bringing home the moose meat and the deer meat and the elk meat that we lived on. I got to see my grandma pulling the nets out of the water and how we worked with the fish. I got to see those things, and that's where the foundations of who I am today were forged. And I believe we're opening that door again by making way for customary care to happen. But it's going to take a culture shift at the front lines of these agencies. And I look to the leadership who have put me in this position, the leadership who are in this room today, to make sure you work with your families and agencies in your community to truly empower this opportunity that's been created here today. I want to thank everybody for being here. I want to thank the leadership of the province of Manitoba. I want to thank the leadership of our communities. The chiefs who are here bringing their colors, the chiefs who are here sitting at the drum, and of course the grand chiefs who are helping guide the thoughts in the legislative discussions that need to happen. Miigwech, thank you.
A beginning. of much more work to be done, but a new way of supporting families. Today we are announcing the legislative changes to the Family Services Act. It sounds kind of bureaucratic and technical, but let me explain what it is. What it is today is we are stepping aside. We are listening to the many, many people before us. Grand Chief Nepinak reminded me about 5 years ago when he met with Premier Selinger.
Today, we have to recognize that there are far too many children who are separated from families, and we must forever be diligent and persistent in making sure we're doing everything we can to bring these families together again